海王问我是塔塔拉。最近因为疫情原因，很多宝宝发邮件的频率越来越高，所以我就收到了一些私信问我关于英文邮件怎么写的问题。我也在 B 站和微博征集了大家对于写英文邮件的具体问题，那今天就把这些问题汇总一下，给大家做一期全网最全的英文邮件指导。全网最全，我保证。今天这期会分成三个大板块，写邮件的大概规则，比如多长的邮件才合适呀，什么才算是礼貌呀。二，写邮件的具体要求和语言，这里面就包括了大家最感兴趣的，比如我该怎么称呼一个不认识的人，主题栏里面要写什么，结尾的时候要不要说 thank you。 最后一个板块会给大家一些具体情境下的建议，比如说我该怎么管老师要推荐信呀，我该用什么语言来问一个问题呀。因为今天这期视频会非常非常的全，我会把每一个问题的时间线放在简介里面，建议大家收藏，这样以后有需要的时候就可以随时过来跟查字典一样查一查你所需要的信息。还有要先说的一点，是因为我也是一个中文母语者，很多你们提的关于英文邮件的问题我也没有办法回答，所以今天我会用 Cambly 这个软件在线和一位英国老师和一位美国老师沟通，看看他们作为母语者是怎么回答这些问题的。
Cambly 是一个线上英语平台，在这儿你24小时随时可以跟外教一对一连线，你可以选择外教的口音，同时你也可以通过这个标志看出来他有没有教师资格证。既然今天咱们主要要聊怎么给老师发邮件，那我们就找两个有国外教学经验的老师来连线吧。
写邮件的基本规则。
How long an email should be? Sometimes I write it too short. I feel I'm not polite enough. But sometimes I really don't have a lot of things to say. Should I keep my email as condensed as possible?
I would keep it as short and simple, to the point as possible.
As a teacher, you wouldn't think a short message is not polite, right?
No, not at all. I would expect the student to give me enough detail that I understand the question. As long as they've done that, the shorter the better.
If the professor sends everyone a notification, do I still need to reply to that?
Usually most of the time when they send a mass email, it's just to notify you about something or a change. You don't always have to reply to every email. You only need to reply if it calls your attention to reply.
Okay. Are there any general rules for how to be polite?
这个问题之前我有个老师给过比较好的答案，他说第一要多用专业语言，不要在邮件里面太随意，第二要保证邮件没有语法和拼写错误，第三不要在邮件里面全都用大写字母，这很冒犯人，最后是尽量不要用加粗、斜体、下划线这种花里胡哨的东西。
写邮件的细节。
So the first question is, I don't know how to write a subject for an email. Do I say question or anything?
There's no rules because it depends upon the teacher. Some of my former teachers will only say put question about this class. So then they know where they need to think. Some teachers like the specifics of the whole question. And it's usually the people that receive a lot of emails where they want to quickly be able to see what their email content is about. And then they can then open and prepare themselves before they actually get to it.
The second question is about the address. So when I write to strangers, for example, an airline company or an office, how do I write the address?
As a general rule, if I'm writing to somebody and I don't know their gender, I will say to whom it may concern. People used to do this, madam. Nowadays, it might be better to say to whom it may concern. That reduces the risk of offending anybody. I'm sure you're very aware from your gender studies, there are many different categories of gender. You have to be careful how you address people.
What if I know the name?
Everything is all about being neutral as possible, unless you've built some sort of connection or have information. Otherwise, just place dear first and last name. If you don't know the person's name, don't use the Mr. or Mrs. because when I hear, hey, mister, I think of little children saying, hey, mister.
When I write to a professor or a teacher, how could I call them?
Usually you have to give them their title. Some professors are more relaxed. They might tell you, call me by my first name. I think it's down to the individual and how well you know them.
You know, sometimes I write to my professors by calling them doctor or professor something, but when they write back to me, they sign off by using their first names. So should I also use their first name because of that?
I would err on the side of caution and keep calling them by a more formal approach. They're more likely to sign their first name. Just because they've signed their name, I don't think gives you the privilege of calling them by their first name in the future.
Okay, the third part is about greeting. What's the difference between dear, hi, and hello?
Dear is usually to address a person in a position of respect. In a formal business, such such as a resume or a cover letter. You'll use dear, Mr., Mrs. And in that situation, you want to make sure you have the person's name. Then there's hi, even though it can be used in most formal settings, it's better to use hello because that actually is more professional. Hi there works when you're sending like mostly a massive email. You're trying to bring attention to a group. So hi there. If you don't know a person's name, you're trying to address something like hello, and then you go straight into telling me.
That's what you said. I think I'm supposed to say dear something to my professor every time. But if he replies with hi, shall I reply with hi as well?
Like me personally, I've only used dear for the first interaction because you're addressing them at the level of respect. And based upon their response, I now have a better understanding of their expectation of me as a student. Now I have a better way of addressing them.
Okay, this one I've been thinking for 3 years. Okay. If that's the first time I write to a professor, for example, I want to ask a question about my assignment, do I need to say anything before I talk about the assignment? Yeah. Do I need to say, hope you are well, or hope I find you well?
Maybe it's because I'm British. I like to be very polite. I would probably say, I hope this email finds you well. I have a small question about such and such. It's a courtesy to say, how are you? Or I hope this email finds you well. You're not being too intrusive. And to me, that counts for a lot. It makes me feel a bit more connected to that person, probably make me respond a bit quicker.
And if I need to say yes. Thank you, where do I put the thank you?
Tag this after the last paragraph, drop down a line, write thank you for your time, take care.
Is there any difference between I appreciate or thank you?
Saying I appreciate goes a step further than just saying thank you. Saying thank you is something that everybody does. It becomes a bit of a throwaway comment. I think it's important to tell them that you appreciate the help that they've provided. I will try to say I appreciate your time, or I appreciate you looking into this for me, or I would appreciate it if you could.
Before the ending, we say best regards or something. Yeah. Are there any differences between best, all the best, and best regards?
I would be more appreciative of somebody who went to the trouble of writing all the best rather than just best, because it does show a lack of
respect.
Maybe not respect, but just the effort it takes to write two extra words. If I saw best, I would just look at it and I would think, okay, you couldn't be bothered to say regards. You know, come on.
What about sincerely? Is that too much?
The general rule is if you start with dear madam, then you finish with sincerely. If you're writing to your professor where you call them by their first name, then you can sign off saying yours faithfully.
So the first one is, if I want to ask for more information or details from that person, how can I say it?
I think I would start off by saying, I was very happy with the information that you provided the other day, but I feel like I don't completely understand, or I don't have complete comprehension of the subject matter. Please, could you give me more detail concerning this subject?
So the second is, for example, I have some problem with my assignment. How can I ask for help?
And to me, Tatala, honesty is always the best policy. Just be honest and say, I'm struggling to find the resources for this essay. Could you give me some books or websites that I could visit to get more information? You don't want to be asking them directly the answers. You're asking them for their guidance, for their suggestion.
If I'm asking for a reference letter, how can I structure the email?
I don't know if I can give you a correct answer on that, because my experience for formal is based upon while I was there, I built a relationship. So I know how to ask, which I basically just structure the message. It's like, hello, Troy, I am applying for a new position. I was reaching out to you, wondering if you will be willing to write me a reference letter highlighting things about me. You'll send me a follow-up email. What type of information are you looking for?
Okay, what if I don't really know him or her?
In that case, be very specific in what you're asking, because you don't know the context of their life, if they're busy. Sometimes, like, it depends. What do you need a reference letter for? Is it for a job? Is it for internship? The language is completely different.
If I send an email to my teacher, how can I let them know that I'm really in urge?
You put the urgency at the end of your message. Okay, can you please respond at your earliest convenience? There you go.
Oh, smart. If I send an email to my teacher and he doesn't reply, how can I remind him politely?
Send a follow-up email with the subject follow-up. follow up previous subject. Because then it's like, follow up. Oh, wait. Oh, yes. They sent me an email.
Then how can I structure my new email? So I say, I sent you an email that you didn't reply.
No, that's rude. It's like saying, I sent you an email. You have to smile. I am following up with you on an email that I sent this day, this time. Was wondering if you've gotten around to seeing the email. But it's just, I am following up with you is the main key point.
How can I argue about my grade?
I have some concerns about my grade. Concerns, because concerns opens it up to question. What kind of concerns do you have? You never want to be misunderstood.
好啦，那今天关于英文邮件的问题就先跟大家说到这儿。相信大家听了两位母语者老师的建议之后，就跟我一样豁然开朗了。其实在生活里面，我们会经常有一些关于英语的问题，或者关于英语国家的社会规范的问题。很多问题我们在网上很难找到特别确切的答案，因为回答的人也不一定是英语母语者。这个时候 Cambly 这种线上和外教沟通的平台就非常的有帮助了。现在注册的话，还可以用我的优惠码获得15分钟的免费课时。好啦，那今天关于英文邮件的视频就到这儿吧，希望你们喜欢。像一开始说的，我会把进度条放在简介里面，大家自行取用。如果大家还有什么关于生活或者学习的问题想问我的话，别忘了留言加关注呀。我是塔拉，我爱你们。
Take care.